And now, your first warning weather. Here's News 8 meteorologist Mallory Brooke.
Of course, snow and wind, the big story when it comes to blizzards. Let's take a quick look at what we've been seeing as far as gusts and sustained winds. Right now, gusts of 29 through Wiscasset, 40 in Lewiston, Auburn, 49 at the Jetport, as well as Sanford. So we're nearing 50-mile-an-hour wind gusts and sustained winds of over 30 miles per hour in both Portland and Sanford. Been keeping an eye on winds across the area at Boston's Logan Airport. We're getting some wind gusts of over 70 miles an hour. So we're keeping our eyes on those high peak wind gusts, and I'll have a list of those coming up for you in just a little bit. Of course, most of us seeing those high wind gusts. Even through Augusta, we have gusts upwards of 47 miles per hour right now. On top of the wind and the snow, we have coastal worries. We have a coastal flood warning along the entire stretch of the mid-coast as well as southern coast, and this is for high tide today. We do have moderate flooding expected. It's going to be your Saturday morning high tide, and portions of Eastern Prom, the trail at Eastern Prom, the Ocean Gateway Pier, and even some low-lying parking lots through Commercial Street in Portland could be flooded, as well as roadways in York County. So we're looking at 25 to 30-foot seas. Plus, you have your wind gusts, and we already have water levels above flood stage. So this is going to come in just around 9 o'clock this morning. So those are our it's a multifaceted system. We have so many different worries. We have the snow, we have the wind, and we do have the flooding potential. Of course, we also have the cold air right now, and that's leading wind chills to be well below zero. Your blizzard warnings go until 4 o'clock this afternoon. Right around 1 o'clock, we should really start to see that heavy snow taper off. So we have some of those bands still hanging along the coastline. We're going to keep them there for just a little bit. And then as we go into the afternoon and evening, we're going to start to see that system push off a little bit faster towards the east. We'll have some cloud cover here still through this evening. So if you need to just put off your cleanup till tomorrow, might be your best bet not to tackle it until all the snow is down. We're still going to have drifting through this evening, and then we'll start to clear out, and you will have sunshine as we go into Sunday. We're also going to get temperatures close to freezing, so it'll soften everything up. It'll be an easy cleanup for you tomorrow. Of course, we have upped our totals along the coast of York County as well as into coastal Cumberland County after already receiving reports of 31.4 inches of snow in Gorham, which is the second highest out of this storm as a total throughout New England. We also have a report of 23 inches in Kennebunk. On the water, we have that storm warning in effect, and we are going to continue seeing temperatures staying into the 20s for today. So, of course, those high snowfall ratios also helping us get these very high snow amounts. Tomorrow, we'll have sunshine, 32 degrees. Another weak storm system affects us Monday. Secondary weak system on Wednesday. So it looks like this is the big talker of the next 7 days. It'll give us plenty of time to clean things up.
All right. Thank you, Mallory.